be discussing how we can fight obesity using technology. Worldwide obesity has more than doubled since 1980. Last year, it was estimated that about 2 billion adults were overweight, and about 600 million of them obese. What's even more worrying is that 42 million children under the age of 5 were overweight or obese. What is the cause of all of this? Well, it's simple. An unbalanced diet and lack of physical activity. But most importantly, bad choices. Most people are unaware of the risks and difficulties that come with being obese. From not being able to look at yourself in the mirror, to suffering from health problems such as diabetes, cancer, and even cardiovascular diseases. These are all consequences to obesity. Thankfully, obesity is not an eternal complication. It can be prevented with maintaining a healthy lifestyle and a lot of hard work. You know one thing the world is definitely not lacking of? Technology. I'm pretty sure soon enough, kids will be receiving an iPad for their first birthday instead of an actual toy. Can you also believe that they're inventing a fridge which emails you when you're in need of going shopping? Crazy, right? And people won't stop there. They will continue to build these magical machines which were once seen in sci-fi movies and now are being brought into reality. So why not take advantage of technology and use it for the greater good? Currently, the European Union is funding a range of high-tech sensors which will monitor the person's food intake and assess obesity risks. One of the risk factors of obesity is actually the time it takes to consume food. So what this small device does is measure the speed at which food is taken in and how the food is being chewed. And if the person is eating too fast, then the device will alert them. This small device can help people's lifestyle go from unhealthy to healthy. This is an innovation which I surely believe in, and I hope many experience a great change when using it. Believe it or not, video games can actually help decrease obesity. About 91% of kids play video games. And the most successful type of video game is actually most motion sensor games. So why not take advantage of their popularity and use it to develop a fitness game so that if kids regularly play this game, they can lose some weight. Nowadays, social media is huge. Everyone has a Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram account. One innovation that uses social media is for people to build a community of support for those suffering from obesity so that they can encourage them to lose some weight. Tests have been done, and it has been concluded that people who use online services actually have a collective decrease in body mass. And an advantage of using social media is that it is cost-effective and practical for day-to-day use. And another innovation that uses social media is for if we merge them with mobile phones and make a game where people all around the world can compete against each other to see who achieves the most physical fitness goals. And what would be even better if companies actually sponsored this game and gave away some cool prizes. Since obesity is at a very high rate within young kids, we need to teach them about this very important matter. Where do kids usually go to learn about stuff? School. However, think about this. Where do kids also go and eat most of their unhealthy food? School. The cafeteria is a dangerous place for kids. There are countless reasons why the cafeteria helps increase obesity. Did you know that the schools only provide the last person in line about 10 minutes to finish their food? As I mentioned before, one of the risk factors of obesity is actually the time it takes to consume the food. And what do you think the kids do when they do not have enough time to finish their food? They revert to buying from vending machines. They throw away a major portion of their food, or even skip lunch entirely. So if extra serving lines were added, then kids will be served much quicker, and hence, have more time to eat. And we could even bring technology into this by having the students pre-order their meal in the morning on some sort of technological device which is linked to the cafeteria, so that they can enjoy their full 30 minutes to eat their healthy dish. And I think that it is very important for the schools to inform the students about their decisions in the cafeteria. They should be choosing healthy, nutritious dishes rather than the unhealthy stuff they eat. What would be also really great if the cafeteria actually labeled their food with what ingredients it has and how many calories it contains. Maybe students could actually be prevented from eating the unhealthy food. In conclusion, technology can have a great impact on our health and well-being. Let us work together on making technology help us become healthier people. Thank you.